Each day I try to paddle about 40 kilometres. I just think it's the most amazing kayak journey of all time, and kayaking is a passion of mine, and so yeah, I'm doing it. Throughout the day I don't usually land, I usually just continuously paddle for 8 to 12 hours. And I have all of the food requirements for the day accessible in the kayak. So yeah, I'm munching my lunch as I'm going along, eating a lot of snacks. When I land in the evening, sometimes there might be a cafe or a restaurant, or I might be having dinner with someone, and other times I might be cooking on my little camping stove and making up some pasta to eat. All different places where I might be staying at the end of the day. Sometimes I might be in a beach in my tent. Sometimes I might be staying at a guest house, other times I might be hosted by a family. Sometimes I'll just arrive somewhere and have no idea where I'm going to stay, and when I land I just have to trust that everything's going to go okay and see what happens. I'm pretty excited that I've arrived in Singapore finally. This is stage 4 of the expedition. It's not really a matter of how long I have left, I just keep going until I get there. I've faced all sorts of hurdles along the way, mostly due to paperwork and bureaucracy for this day and age, for crossing over between countries and for permits for paddling. Some other things like big storms on the sea, maybe some big sections where I have not been able to land and I've had to paddle for many, many hours at a stretch. In India, I got attacked by some fishermen. That's not to say that that happens everywhere in India. It's a fantastic country, but that was a very big challenge of the trip. I guess a lot of people don't really understand what I'm doing. So sometimes that can be a little bit challenging when you're tired at the end of the day. And you know, some countries you get all these people crowding around you, coming to have a look and see what you are, and you feel like you're in a zoo. The kayak is 5 meters long. It has compartments that you can put everything inside, and that keeps it all watertight inside there. And I carry about maybe 100 kilos of stuff once I get everything in there with all the water and the food. So that's pretty heavy. And then I just eat my food to get it lighter as I'm going along. I've got things like a tent, camping stove, first aid kit, repair kit, clothes. Yeah, so much stuff, it really adds up. It's really hard to say what's the most memorable, because there's so many good parts of the journey, you know. Places where I'd like to go back to are getting to be a very long list. I really love Turkey. That was a really fantastic, welcoming country to paddle in, but also some really beautiful paddling locations. I loved India, and it took a while to get used to the crowds of people there, but after a while you just start to miss that and sort of you fall in love with that place. I loved Bangladesh because they just wanted it to be the most amazing place you've ever been, and everyone was like really cool there. Going out of your way to help people that you've never met in your life before, because so many people have done that for me, that's definitely some things that I'll take away from the trip.